I'm back. So, hello ladies and gentlemen, to the third episode of the Borderlands 1 series. Now, we're gonna go turn in some quests. Last episode, we finished the Mind Gate Key mission. Finished Mind Gate Key, or getting the Mind Gate Key, whatever you want to say. I've said pretty much everything that you could say. I'm gonna go this way. And ran into rocks.
Everything you've faced up until now has been simple.
Yes.
You're about to face a real challenge in Sledge. Do not underestimate him.
But we're not going immediately after him. We're actually heading over to the Firestone Bounty Board. But yeah, we'll head over to the Firestone Bounty Board. And I guess we'll also check with Chef Sanders. Yes, I know, Claptrap. I was heading over there. But you told me about Shep, so I figured I'd pick up a quest. Now, let's head over to Shep's, well, to the Firestone Bounty Board, and then we'll complete all the quests. Do-do-do. I don't know, I kinda seen some just a few moments ago. That Outlet sniper rifle is a lot better. I think we'll go. I think we'll go with the Pearl sniper. Or the vicious one. I'll swap it out from the Masher for the moment. The Masher has a bad fire rate. But if I'm able to use it for a little bit, I'll hopefully get another one. But if it gets annoying, I've still got the backup Masher. Hey, we leveled up again. Well, I say again, because I'm recording this pretty much immediately after the last episode. Damn. Alright. So, do we want to do? I can do those now. That's a easy quest to do. And that's a pretty easy quest to do. So I think we'll go ahead and stay in the Earth Badlands for the moment. Complete these quests. And then head in to the Arid Hills. Complete that quest where we can kill Mo and Marley, then we'll go do the Shock Crystal quest, because that's another quest we have to do, and that's one that can be found as a pain by some people. If you're not at the right level, it can be real difficult, but if you have the equipment and you're at the right level, it's not bad. It's not that bad of a quest. I don't know why I took the long way around. My Masher for this. It's a little bit better. them all out in one shot. That's done. That's free XP and money, pretty much. Where do I want to go in here? I was about to go into mine. But no, we're gonna go take care of the combat rifle, which, I mean, was right next to where we were, so I don't know why I went back there. I'm just doing it in a little weird of an order for me. I kind of went a different path than normal, than I'm used to, pretty much. And normal for me. So, bandit killer, dead. Bit of ammo needed. Up here. Take the money. Ooh. There. Grab that. Nothing much here for the moment. Get that rowdy machine gun. Let's see. I just wanted to check everything here. Make sure we grab as much loot as possible. Looting's always a smart idea. Might be able to find some extra ammo. On occasion. And I'm hoping that we can do this in these next few quests. Shouldn't be difficult. No turning these. I'm gonna save the Skag Slaughter Dome till after we complete all these side quests. That's probably gonna be the last thing I'm gonna do before heading into the mine. Considering the mine can be a pain. There we go. So, let's take a drive here. Over to you. All right. So, I think I'm gonna do the shot quest actually first. So I can power up Bloodwing, have him be able to do some extra damage, and stop being so weak. And I'll be able to get a. SDU in the backpack. kind of work that I'm wanting to do. Though the other master I have might be weaker. It has a better firing. And I can rely on it a little bit more. Guarantee that you're gonna need to fight them practically. They get angry at you as soon as you go up there. And you kinda need their crystals that are up there. They're pretty much guarding. Essentially, pain. The low levels. Here, like the skags up here. Whoa, he's a fast boy. I'm gonna focus on the fire skag. All the ammo and money around that they dropped. Kill you. Alright. Let's see. Those aren't very good, but there we go. Alright. We'll tend to that hot trap in a moment. Crap. Yeah, I really don't want it. Rocket launchers aren't good unless they're spread. Way. Oh, this one right here. Put it, pull it into that. Alright. He's dead. He's dead. He's dead. You're dead. You're dead. Oh. It's more right SMG that he's got. Trigger as he smacked me, so can't send me out. Take that up. Alright. I am done here. Let's just go turn in this quest cop trap. This one, I'm pretty sure, doesn't show you anything, so... It's time to head on. Turn this quest in, and then we will be done for this episode. So, though I'm not going to end it off until I'm there, and I think I'm going to leave this episode off with a question for all of you.
Time for a nice relaxing time.
Do you think that they will split up the revolver and repeater ammo in Borderlands 3 once again? If they do, they might bring back the mashers once again, considering they're quite strong, as you've seen. Personally, I don't think so. Just so that they don't really have to worry about bringing back the mashers. I think they're going to go with what they did for Borderlands 2 in pre-sequel. Oh, hey, we got points to spend. And we got a relic. Well, an elemental artifact. Meaning that Ludwig will now do some shock damage. See here. Let's see what Bloodwing can do. About 230 damage. That's pretty good. Alright. Well, I'm going to end it off here. And I will see you guys in the next episode. So...